Mag-subscribe ka na.
Hello mga Bweks, magandang gabi sa inyong lahat, galaw-galaw para hindi mapaimbornal. Hello sa ating mga subscribers dyan, ganun din sa ating mga new subscribers, welcome to Parade of Beauty. If you are here tonight, welcome to the new era of beauty. Beauty is in you. Hello mga Bweks, kamusta naman kayo? Na-mess? Ba't wala ako ngayon? Naluloka ako. Na-miss ko kayong lahat. Ayan, inaabangan nga natin ang interview ni Atisa Manalo dito kay Doktora... Dr. Vic, yung ba yung basa doon? Hello sa lahat dyan, sa mga nanonood. Sa mga nanonood po dyan, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Click your notification bell para mas updated kayo sa ating magic every day and night sa mundo ng pageantry. And please like this video. Maraming salamat po sa mga nag-like sa inyo. Ah. Ay, ayan na. Ganda!
My iPhone. Yeah. Hello! Hi, it's the Atisa. Yeah, I have a little problem now, but I can't hear you clearly. Let's wait just a little bit.
Okay. Wait lang mga Bweks, inaayos ko.
Hi everybody. Hi. So the main have some problem. Can you repeat it? Okay.
Ang ganda ni Atisa. Meron tayong pa-poll dyan sa baba. Hello sa mga nanonood po. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and like this video. Thank you so much.
The first guest to come to the new series. So we have some problem with technical.
Babasahin ko lahat ng comments niyo mamaya after ng interview.
Yeah. So, what are you feeling right now? Yeah, so now to break the ice with the audience, can you begin by show out your name?
Okay. Hello everyone.
Can you just begin by show out your name?
My name? Okay, hi everyone. I am Maria Atisa Manalo. I am 27 years old and I will represent the Philippines in the first ever Miss Cosmo International.
Yeah. Có thể tăng cái tiếng lên chút. Okay. Wow, now I can hear you clearly. Yeah. So, thank you for joining with me and Miss Cosmo tonight. I think that many fans and many followers of you are waiting for you for a very long time before since I post about this live stream, many people just say thank you for inviting Atisa, and they very eager to see you tonight. So now let's look back a little bit at your past, because I know that you joined some beauty passions seeing you very young.
Yes.
So what did motivate you to join the passion for the first time?
I joined my first pageant when I was 10 years old, and mm-hmm. the reason for that is I was born into a not well-off family. We, like, our socioeconomic background is more on the poor side, so I wanted to find a way to help help my family put myself through school and also help my education in the future. So I decided to join my first pageant at 10 years old in my school because the grand prize was free tuition. Wow. For a whole year. And
uh-huh.
Doing, you know, free tuition for a whole year is such an amazing prize for joining a pageant.
Yeah, so you are very experienced beauty queen because you chose the pageant when you were so young.
I was young.
And as I know, you have a very high positions on the beauty pageant that you had chosen in the past. So can you share me some beautiful and sweet memory when you chose that passion? Because I know that you not only chose the Philippines passion, but also other international beauty passions. So what's the, your memory when you chose, and can you share some lovely and some happy moment you experienced there?
To me, really, the big part of joining beauty pageants is meeting people from all over the world. I have represented the Philippines before in an international stage, and I am glad to have met women from all over the world that are impactful in their own way, that are beautiful in their own way. And these are people that up until now are part of my life, and I would have not met them otherwise if I did not join pageants. So I think, yeah, that's the most memorable and happiest thing for me whenever I join a pageant, the people I meet.
Yeah, so it's very many beautiful moments that you cannot forget in your life, I guess that. So how about Miss Cosmo 2024? Why do you decide to turn this to participating as a beauty queen and representing for the Philippines? Why did you choose Miss Cosmo? Okay. Yeah.
It is the first ever edition of Miss Cosmo International, and I came from a startup industry. I have experience in building a new company from nothing, and I think that it is a privilege to be part of something new, to be part of something big in creation, and I want to be part of the first ever Miss Cosmo International, and hopefully be the queen that will represent the impactful company that is Miss Cosmo.
Yeah. I think that the competition is different, and also the beauty passions is different from each country to that country, and with the international competition like Miss Cosmo 2024, what do you most impressed about this, and do you think that you have well prepared right now for the Miss Cosmo?
I think what I'm most impressed of when it comes to Miss Cosmo International is the part where Miss Cosmo wants to do something that has never been done before in the pageant industry. And being part of something like that, having an impactful platform to implement positive, long-lasting change, that is something that I am most impressed of with Miss Cosmo International. And that other question, yes, I am very much prepared for Miss Cosmo International.
Yeah, I can see your decision. And do you feel any exciting or thrilling right now? Because the Miss Cosmo is coming just in 1 month later, and because in the schedule of Miss Cosmo, I see it's a very hard working days with many activity in Miss Cosmo, and which part of the competition that you most interested in or most focused on right now?
There are a lot of things that will happen in Miss Cosmo, and I'm really excited for a lot of them. I know based on our schedule, we are traveling in different provinces of Vietnam. Mm-hmm. And the first time I was in Vietnam was for Miss Cosmo also. So I'm excited to see different parts of Vietnam. Yeah. You know, that's something that I think is an experience that is very unique to being a beauty pageant contestant in Miss Cosmo. We are gonna be toured around in the most beautiful places of Vietnam. We're gonna eat the best Vietnamese food. We're gonna meet Vietnamese people, and for me, that's the most exciting part of the competition.
Well, I remember about you when you first time come to Vietnam. At that time, I remember it's in the launching conference of Miss Cosmo 2024.
Yes.
And I just look at you for a far distance. I look at you on the stage, and you look very attractive and stunning on the stage that I cannot forget you till now. I'm very looking forward to see your performance on the next journeys with Miss Cosmo. And thank you for loving Vietnam and Vietnamese people, Vietnamese culture. I agree for the next time when you come and join me, Cosmo, you have more time to explore more things about Vietnam, including the foods, the culture, the beauty, sceneries. And also, you can make friends with many lovely Vietnamese people, including me.
I'm very excited for that, Doctor. Very excited.
Mm-hmm. So let's talk a little bit about, because I know that you are prepared many things right now for the competition, but also I know that you do at the same time many community projects, seeing you become the beauty queen of the Philippines. So can you say a little bit about some project that you are focusing right now on the community?
I think one of the biggest projects that I have right now is of Allen Academy. Our aim is to change the educational landscape of the Philippines. We are ranked as one of the lowest when it comes to the global education index. And my hope is in the future, our education will be competitive enough globally, and I want to spearhead that movement for our educational system in the Philippines.
Yeah, it's also a very meaningful process, and I truly believe that it will inspire many people, not only in the Philippines, but also all around the world. So I wish you can do more in the future to make the world a better life. Yeah. Because this year I'm the healthcare director, so it's a very first time of me to do a show like this. So I am going to hear something about you. Is there anything you need me to support when you come to Vietnam as a healthcare director? Do you have some information or any skincare tip or a beauty care tip that I can advise you?
For sure, I want skincare tips. I think I have a problem with my makeup. When I put on a lot of makeup, my skin gets a little dry. So if you can help me with that, and that'll be great, because we'll have makeup on for like a whole month when we're in Vietnam, and it's important to let your skin breathe, I know, and take care of your skin. So if you can help me with that, that would be amazing. That would be great.
Yeah. I think that your skin now look very strong and glowy, and I wish that you can keep this skin condition during our journeys. So, because in Vietnam, we have a very busy schedule, and we travel a lot, not only in Ho Chi Minh City, where the competition is held, but also some other cities, such as Hanoi, Ninh Bình, Đà Lạt. The weather, it changes a lot when we travel. So I think that you should to prepare some item in your bag for you to use anytime you want, such as moisturizing cream, hydration mist, and some recovery mask. Because when we change from Ho Chi Minh City to Hanoi or Đà Lạt, maybe the weather, it changes a lot. the temperature is lower and also the humidity is lower also. So your skin easy to lose water. And at that time, we need to moisturize it at the most as you can. So a mask, some items just as serum or cream is necessary for you at that time.
Okay, I'll keep note.
I saw that you have is available in your bus for every journey you go.
Okay, I will do that.
Yeah, and because the schedule of my Miss Cosmo 2024 is very busy, so maybe tell to you it is you must keep the balance of the physical health and also the mental health. Because maybe sometimes you don't have enough time to sleep or to do exercise or something to make you balance the physical and also mental health. So how about your habits right now? Do you do exercise regularly or just when you have free time?
I make sure to exercise regularly. It is part of my regimen. I have to work out to feel better. You know, but when you work out, your walk is just different. You feel happier. You just have a beat into your walk, unlike if you don't work out. So I make sure to work out because I know that more than it helps my physical body, it does help my mental health as well.
Yeah, so now I know why you have a very slim face and a very sporty body. Yeah, so sometimes I'm very lazy. Sometimes I know that exercise is very good and necessary for our lives and our health. But sometimes I just feel so lazy.
Yeah.
Especially when I have a busy schedule, so I just visit one time, two time, and day by day.
And three times.
in some time of my life, such as the this month, I think that I do exercise not regular as I want. I just do it one time a week, and I think that it's not enough. So I will learn from you. Yeah.
It's good to try.
So, I think that keep a habit of doing exercise is more important than doing it too much or too hard. So I will try my best from now. So let's talk a little bit about the Miss Cosmo and your goals as Miss Cosmo 2024. What's your goals? To have a high positions or to do some special thing on this journey? What's your goals?
As an entrepreneur, I feel like based on my experience, I know that there is more to contribute in the world. And what I really want to happen is for me to be able to contribute in my community. I desire to create long-lasting impact in my community and inspire people, empower people. I am today because people empowered me in my life's aspiration.
Yeah.
So my hope is that I can enable someone to achieve their dreams as well and to create changes in their own lives.
Yeah. Oh, so meaningful and so caring of you to do many useful and helpful projects like this. I can see many followers, many fans of you are with many hearts fighting right now. So is there anything you want to say to your followers and your fans, not only from the Philippines, but also the other country?
Of course. I am always very thankful that you will continue to support me. And I really hope that we spread love and positivity and we try to stay away from hate and all negative comments, because the community is only as good as the people that are part of it. So if you want to make Miss Cosmo International really the new standard of pageants, I think we all need to stay away from being negative and just keep supporting your girls from wherever country you are. And yeah, like continue supporting the girls and supporting their vision for the future.
Yeah, wow, so inspiring. I think that not only your fans are very happy right now, but from your sharing, maybe I become the new fans of you from tonight. So let's talk a little bit about the topics of this competition, is impactful beauty. In your opinion, what is the beauty that can make impact to our society, to our world?
You know, the thing about our society is we still value beauty. We still put value into how a person looks physically. And if I can use that physical beauty into making people listen to me, in that way I can start creating lasting impact and positive change. I think that's what beauty is for. Like, we gotta use it smartly. We gotta use it as a tool and not let it carry us into things that are not good for us.
Yeah. Yeah, I totally agree with you. I think that the image of beauty needs to come from inside, from our hearts, from our brains, from our love and from our caring to the other, not just only the beauty, the outside appearance of beauty. So I wish that you can express and inspiring much more when you chose the very exciting journeys with Miss Cosmo this year. And so do you concerns on about the other contestants right now? Because when I follow on Miss Cosmo page, I'm very curious with many contestants from other countries. They appear on the page day by day, many new faces, and they are all very beautiful, very talented women, and also they have many impacts to the in the country that they come from. So what do you think about the other contestants this year?
I really think that all the other contestants are sent here to Miss Cosmo International because their countries believe that they are impactful, that they can create change. And I am excited to meet all these women from all over the world, because these are going to be my sisters for a whole month. These are going to be my sisters for a lifetime. And who knows, like when women band together and when women meet together, sometimes we can create amazing things and we can create amazing changes. So I'm really excited to meet everyone.
Yeah, I truly believe in that. And I'm so looking forward to see the interaction between you all. And I believe that Miss Cosmo 2024 is a very exciting and joyous journeys for all of us, not just one beauty queen from one country. So
yes,
now, how to change the atmosphere, maybe we turn to some mini game.
Okay.
Can you talk with me?
Yeah,
it's just a very easy and funny game. So because you have come to Vietnam once, can you speak Vietnamese just a little bit?
I can. Xin chào. Come on.
Cảm ơn. Yeah, it says thank you and xin chào. Yeah, it's hello. Yeah.
You want to learn how to speak more Vietnamese? Like, no, how are you? I'm good. Thank you.
Okay. Yeah, I'm ready to teach you Vietnamese right now. So are you good in Vietnam? We will say like this. Bạn khỏe không?
Bạn khỏe
Bạn
không?
khỏe không?
Bạn
yeah.
khỏe không?
Yeah. Yeah, excellent. Bạn khỏe không? Exactly.
Bạn khỏe không?
Yeah, exactly. You're very talented on the language. So if you want to show your love to another person, you can say it in Vietnam. Tôi thích bạn. It's the same as I like you in English.
I like
in Vietnam. Yeah, you say tôi thích bạn.
Tôi thích bạn.
Yeah, tôi thích bạn, Atisa. Bạn thật dễ thương. You're so cute. I like you, Atisa. So can you teach me in Philippines?
Okay, I'll teach
bạn.
You.
I want to say that I like you in Philippines.
I can teach you mahal kita instead.
Mahal kita.
Mahal kita.
Mahal kita.
Yes.
I don't know. Yeah, but I will be busy day by day. So when I meet you again in Miss Cosmo, I will tell you that I like you in the Philippines.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so now we change the game a little bit. Now this is a choosing game. I will offer you two options. And you must choose just one.
Okay.
The
okay.
one
that's hard.
That you yeah, the one that you prefer or the one that you think is more important, you just choose one.
Okay.
Okay, are you
so
ready?
I think one that is more important.
yeah. Maybe because you will see it right now. Your prefers or the thing you think is more important. So now, the first, no hairstyling or no makeup. If you have to choose, which one you choose? Which will you choose?
I'll choose no makeup.
No makeup. Yeah, because you look so beautiful in your natural way. Uh-huh. I guess so. The same to me. Yeah, it's the same to me. Because I think that makeup by ourselves is more easier than hairstyling by ourselves.
Yes.
Would you agree?
Agree.
Oh, hairstyling is very difficult. Yeah. So the next time we can see as a person in natural face, but with a very gorgeous hairstyle.
Yeah,
that's better. Yeah. So, turn to the next. Wow, I think it's very easy for you. Eat less or exercise more.
Exercise more.
Yeah, I can guess your answer. Because I questioned you before and you told that you very love in doing exercise, so exercise more.
Exercise
yeah,
more,
and
definitely.
Yeah. Do you have any advice for the woman that just want to reduce the weight just by eating less and less? Can you advise them something?
I really think that us people, we are meant to move, and it is very important for us to be active, to have active lifestyles. And I think it is not about how much you eat. I think it is about how much you burn, how much you actually move your body.
Yeah.
And because personally, I eat a lot, and I think that I can only eat a lot because I move a lot, I exercise a lot. So I think it's important to really exercise and move your body, because when you move your body, you actually feel happy.
Yeah, I agree with this, because I think that's doing exercise not just good for your health, was also good for your mental health. You can release on the stress, on the worry during you do exercise, and you feel feeling so good after doing some exercise. Yeah.
Very much so. Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Totally agree. So maybe I think that it's also an easy question for you. I can guess the answer, but I still ask you. Outer appearance or inside value?
Yeah, definitely inner value. You know, it helps sometimes to have a good physical appearance, because I wouldn't be able to join Miss Cosmo International if that wasn't the case.
Mm-hmm,
and
yeah.
I think I'd be a hypocrite to say that it is not important. But inner value at the end of the day is what makes people like you, and what makes people stay with you, or what makes people actually love you.
Yeah.
It is important what you have inside of you, and it really shows, you know, it what you have inside of you, it shines outwards.
Yeah. I think that the outside appearance is just attracting people for voice. But the inside values is make them keep the love with you with the time. And that's why many fans of you are following you, loving you, supporting you, and encourage you till now. Because I believe in that you have a very strong inside you, a strong belief inside you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you, doctor.
Come to the last one, and I think that it is the most difficult for you.
Okay.
Are you ready?
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm
ready. Because to me, when I see the question, I can't choose. I can't choose. Yeah, I can't miss a choice.
I have to pick one. No removal, no
baby. No removal, or no sounding, no button sounding. In a very exalted day, very busy day, you just want to go to sleep, and you just have a time just for one.
It happens.
We're good to choose.
Removal. I cannot bathe, doctor. It's so hot in the Philippines. It's so humid. I'm going to stay.
Yeah.
It's a day. No makeup removal instead.
So difficult to
do. I do it anyway sometimes when I fall asleep. I fall asleep with makeup. I know it's bad. Don't do that.
Yeah, I totally agree with you. Because I'm a dermatologist, so everything you can progress, include your lover or your husband, but don't forget to remove makeup before you sleep. Because it's more painful to your skin. The acne, irritation, allergies, many things can come from forgetting makeup removal. So I think that is a very so intelligent of you. No sounding is also very terrible in a hot weather like Philippines or Ho Chi Minh City. But maybe in a very exotic day we can do it next morning after we wake up.
Good try.
So I think that well, the audience very love this meeting. And feel, you are very lovely during the mini games. So now let's talk a little bit about the beauty trends in your country right now. I can see you have a natural beauty, and Philippine women's natural beauty just like you. Or now, what beauty trends is dominating in Philippines right now?
I think the beauty trends that are dominating the Philippines right now would be the Korean style. We really love
Korean makeup.
Yes, and the Korean stars are at the rise like no other time before than now. And I think that Korean is the most trending beauty trend so far in the Philippines.
Well, so it's the same to Vietnam here. in the past, maybe I think that not only Korean but also Thailand a face on the trends in Vietnam. The makeup style or the skincare routine they follow from Koreans, but till now some young women they love Thailand. They also love Thailand trend. Just in some procedures, after this procedure, you know, such as some injection or even some plastic surgery, they also love the Korean style and also the Thailand style at the same time. But maybe Korean is much more. It's more.
Thai people are really good at doing their makeup, so I understand why it would be a big trend in Vietnam as well.
Yeah. Many makeup artists from Vietnam, they come to Thailand to learn about the new trend. And that's why when they come back to Vietnam, the Thailand trend, especially on makeup,
is
from very cold place. Yeah. So how about the skincare? Is there any trend on skincare in the Philippines? They love natural products, organic products, or some active treatments or some treatment products.
For a while, I also saw a rise of the Korean skincare in the Philippines, but I think it died down a little bit just because the climate is so much different from Korea. Korea gets cold in the Philippines, you know, it's usually hot. So I think we are more focused on just taking care of our skins properly, and I've seen also some influx of Thai products because the weather in Thailand is very much similar to the Philippines. I think that's where we are right now with that.
I can understand this because the same I think that's the weather in Vietnam, especially in hot city like Ho Chi Minh City where I'm living right now, very similar to the Philippines. So although the people love Korean style and Korean product, but because the different in the weather, different in skin types, so some product is not proper for them. So now in Vietnam, we have a new trend that we change from some product to some treatment procedure with some machines, with some injection, and a very favorite trend right now in Vietnam is ingest some nutrients, especially HA, hyaluronic acid, directly into the skin to make it glowy and stronger and look it more energetic, you know? So how about this in Philippines?
Is it different from fillers, doctor? Is hyaluronic acid different from fillers?
Yeah. So have you tried it before?
I haven't tried hyaluronic acid actually. I am willing to try if it's something that will make your skin glow. But I think in the Philippines I've noticed that there is a trend in people getting more and more plastic surgery. Like plastic surgery is super accessible now in the Philippines.
Wow.
Like, there are a lot of clinics available now, like before. And I think it also was carried by the short-lived trends of social media. You know, we see in social media all these women who are almost perfect and altered.
And usually they
get a little bit of plastic surgery. So I think there is that trend now that more Filipinos are doing plastic surgery.
I see. In the past, many women, they had to follow the standards of beauty. And icons are thus artificial beauty by plastic surgery. But however, the trend has changed right now. Now in Vietnam, we prefer some non-invasive procedure, such as using some lifting machines or some injection, but just to make the skin glowy or make the face change a little bit. Not too much, and the face still look very natural and feminine after the treatment.
Yeah, a little bit of improvement. I think like in anything, it is up to the person really if they want to improve their physical appearance. And, you know, sometimes it actually does give you a self-esteem boost. I think it's just dangerous when you try it, when you do it too much, yeah. when you're not doing it yeah. for yourself anymore. Like, it's dangerous if you just try to follow trends because mm-hmm. because you want to be part of the trend. But if you're doing it for yourself, I think it's your body. Like, you can do... You can do it. What you want to do with it.
Yeah. It's so smart of you. In every choice you make, I think that's because you have knowledge, you have the carefully, and also you have time to research very carefully about this. So you know the pros and cons of the procedure, so you can choose it. Just by you, not by the trends or the effects of other people.
Yeah.
Because it's also the thing that I usually, I often advise my client. No, many young women, they just come to my clinic and they want to change their face, change their body as much as they can.
Mm-hmm.
But they still look good.
Yeah.
Original, they still look very lovely,
yeah.
and they look the natural beauty good.
Yeah.
But because maybe just following the trends, so I usually explain them that don't need to follow the trend.
Yeah.
Just look at you in the mirror, hearing from the voice inside you, and you just need to do just something to make you feel better. Not on thing that change you to. Another person.
I really think, doctor, that for the younger generation, especially the younger girls now, it is a lot more harder because they grew up watching all these people that they're supposed to look up to, looking a certain
yeah.
way. And I really think that it's starting to affect the self-esteem of young girls. I have a little sister, so I know how much trends affect how they think of themselves. And I think that we have to be careful in accepting these trends as our own. Like, we gotta make sure that we're doing it for ourselves. And all the standards that are placed for beauty, I don't think we have to accept them as standard for ourselves, especially
yeah,
for the young
yeah.
girls, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, totally agree. Yeah. I know that you are very famous and you are also an influencer on the social media. So your voice is very important. And I believe that with your voice, many young women will know about the true beauty and you will do the impactful beauty as the slogan of Miss Cosmo 2024, impactful beauty, to inside of you. Yeah.
Thank you, Dr.
So I think that tonight I'm feel very happy to have you here. I'm a little bit thrilled because it is the first time I do a live stream like that in English and also become the host of the show.
Wow.
You know, as a doctor, usually I'm just the West. And I have an MC to ask me something, and I just
yeah.
answer the question. But now, the position
so,
changed.
Well,
I become the host, and you are the guest. So I'm a little bit nervous about this. But thank you to you. Thank you so much. Because you make it more easier, more lovely. And
I'm glad.
I think that's even... the atmosphere is so good tonight. So now, the last question. I think that many young women following you, and they will be inspired by you to want to join some beauty patients. So what do you want to advise them to prepare for the beauty patient to be ready and to maybe become the winner of any beauty patient?
I think for anyone who wants to join a beauty pageant, especially if you are a young girl, I think you've just got to think why you want to do it. A lot of people, they do it to seek out their validation, to seek the validation
yeah.
of people. And I think it's important. know why you're doing it. If you are doing it for yourself, to gain some confidence, to boost your self-esteem, to meet new friends, yeah. I think that's great. You should do it, and you should push for it, and you should do your best so you can win whatever pageant you're joining. Just make sure that you are doing it for yourself, and you're not doing it to seek validation from other people.
So impressive. I think that it will inspire many followers and many audience that watching the live stream right now. So thank you again for joining with me tonight. And now to say goodbye in Vietnam, I will teach you more okay. Vietnamese word. If you want to say goodbye, you say the tạm biệt. Yeah, wow, excellent. Tạm biệt. So I teach you one more.
Okay.
Because now it's time for sleep. So if you want to wish someone a sweet dream, sleep time, you say it in Vietnam. Chúc ngủ mơ.
Chúc ngủ mơ.
Let's try again. Chúc ngủ ngon.
Chúc ngủ ngon.
Okay, yeah, better. Much more better. Yeah, so thank you again, Atisa, and
thank
I wish you a sweet dream. Yeah, chúc ngủ ngon, Atisa. See you next time in Vietnam. Yeah, goodbye and sleep tight.
You too, doctor. Great job on your first posting.
Thank you.
Bye, doctor.
Bye.
Thank you so much. Bye, everybody.
Goodbye to all the audience. Thank you for watching us tonight. And please follow the series Hit the Road with Miss Cosmo 2024. Thank you and goodbye.
Hello mga Bwex, hello sa mga nanonood dyan. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and click notification para mas updated kayo sa ating mga chika everyday and night sa mundo ng pageantry. And please like this video. Thank you. First and foremost, ayun, kudos kay Atisa Manalo. Talagang pinaghandaan niya ang kanyang interview kay Doktora. At kahit naman ito talaga ay nasa Instagram lang, ay talaga namang kitang-kita yung ganda ni Atisa Manalo. Lutang-luto ang kanyang ganda. Knowing na, alam niyo yung Instagram, parang ano lang yan, di ba? Pag nagla-live ka, para lang normal na ano yan. Pero kitang-kita yung ganda ni Atisa Manalo, yung kanyang beauty na pa-asimple ng makeup. She's so gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous. Kahit na dito lang sa Instagram ito, no? So, ayun, una ko napansin kay Atisa Manalo, napaka-ano niya, napaka-classy ng beauty niya, no? Una pa lang lumabas siya sa screen, sabi ko, oh my God, parang nasa Miss Cosmo na siya. Ayun, Lucky Tan, ang babaw naman ng mga sinasabi niya. Well, actually, napansin mo yun, but kasi depende rin yun sa tanong. Kumbaga, syempre, simple lang yung tinanong sa kanya. So, hindi niya naman kailangang magbato ng napakalalim na ano, ng napakalalim na, na mga kasagutan. For me, yung mga sinagot ni Atisa Manalo, tama lang. Kumbaga, hindi siya yung parang overly exaggerated. Kung ano yung tinanong sa kanya, yun lang yung sinagot niya. Kumbaga, nandun pa rin yung pagiging, kumbaga, on point na mga sagutan ni Atisa Manalo. Nakita ko improvements sa mga sagutan ni Atisa Manalo. And aside from that, napansin ko na si Doktora ang likot-likot ng mga mata pag nagtatanong, no? Parang lamon na lamon siya ni Atisa Manalo. Kasi sinasagot din ni Doktora yung tanong niya. Although, merong mga sagot si Doktora. Hindi ko na maalala kung saang part. Basta may mga sagot si Doktora na magaganda rin. Magaganda rin yung hugot ni Doktora. But, merong mga part na medyo na-annoyed ako ng konti na si Doktora always saying, I'm a doctor, blah, 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 blah. I mean, you don't have to say several times that you are a doctor, because before this interview started, when this interview got posted few days ago, we already knew that you are a doctor. Diba? I mean, you don't have to flaunt it. I'm a doctor, blah, 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 blah. Yun ang napansin ko ay Doktora. Mm-mm. Parang medyo, ayun. And then, nakita ko yung mga comments sa comment section. Nakakahiya yung mga Pinoy. Sa totoo lang, nakakahiya. Kasi, syempre, lalaban ang ating kandidata sa international pageant. And of course, nasa Instagram account ni Doktora. Pag nakita mo yung mga comments doon, grabe yung mga Pinoy. Talagang sinasabi, okay lang na dito, alam ba, nagko-comment tayo dito, ganyan-ganyan sa ano sa live natin. No? Kasi ito, live naman natin. Kumbaga, ako I can say na, oh my God, it's quite a bit hard to understand what Doktora Bigna saying. Kasi nga yung language barrier, yung accent, ganyan-ganyan. But what can we do? We can't do anything about that, right? Kasi nga, kumbaga, yun yung ano nila, yun yung language nila. Kumbaga, I mean, yun yung accent nila. Actually, I have a lot of Vietnamese friends here in Australia. Especially, I got some friends in Vietnam. And aside from that, I have some workmates Vietnamese. To be honest, the way they speaks, yung accent talaga napakahirap, lalo na kung bagong salta sa Australia. But, you know, they will, the improvements nagaganap parang day by day. So, nag-iiba yung accent nila kasi nga nandito na sila sa Australia, no? But come to think of it, we have to respect kung ano yung accent nila. Kasi, I mean, hindi natin yung pwedeng, hindi natin kailangan pagtawanan, di ba? Kasi, to be honest, honestly speaking, hindi naman lahat ng Pinoy maganda yung accent sa English. Diba? Kumbaga meron din mga Pinoy na hindi ganun kaganda yung English. So, kung yung mga comments doon, sa comment section, yung mga kababayan nating Pinoy na parang, oh my God, nosebleed yung ano ni Doktora, ganyan, 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 ganyan. Sana inano na lang, sana ginaylinggo na lang para walang makaintinding. Kasi may mga nanonood, mga Vietnamese eh. Diba? I mean, sa mga, tayo mga Pilipino, ayaw nating nasasabihan tayo na, oh, ganito, ganyan. O paano pag sinabihan tayo, oh my God, akala ko ba yung Philippines, American accent. Bakit ganun yung accent niya? Diba? Ayaw nating nasasabihan tayo. Kasi, to be honest, hindi naman tayo perfect. Yung English natin, ako ngayon, English ko, hindi ko kinakahiya na minsan, or kadalasan, meron akong wrong grammar or grammatically wrong, no? But I don't care. Ganun ako magsalita eh. As long as naiintindihan niyo ako, because I believe, hindi barrier yung, anong tawag dito, kung paano ka magsalita, or whatsoever, kung ano yung accent mo, kung, kasi nasa ano yan eh, kung paano mo sinasabi, at kung paano ka naiintindihan yung tao, no, nang usap mo, yung mahalaga doon, yung understanding, hindi yung accent. Kasi ganun si Doktore, eh. Kumbaga ganun siya magsalita, yun yung accent niya, we can't do anything about it. Pero, naiintindihan ko siya. Naiintindihan ko yung binubugan ni Doktora. Although siguro immune na ako, kasi nga marami akong mga friends, I mean, napapaligiran ako ng mga Vietnamese, no? So, immune na ako sa kanilang accents. Kaya siguro, napipick up ko ng mabilisan kung ano yung sinasabi nila. Or yung sinasabi ni Doktora. But anyway, merong mga part na hindi nga, yung parang mapapagano, ano yung sinabi niya? Tapos biglang, ako to. Halimbawa, pinapanood ko si Doktora, so ano yung sinabi niya? Tapos biglang, boom, nandun na sa utak ko, ah, okay, na ano ko na. Kasi nga, immune ako sa accent nila. Pero yung reaction ng ating mga kababayan Pinoy doon sa comment section, nakakahiya. Nakakahiya lang na parang, syempre, may mga Vietnamese na nanonood doon, for sure, may mga chay-chay. Ayan, wag na kayo magtaka pag lumabas pa yun sa social media, pag in-screenshot ng mga ating mga supit bahay. Di ba, parang ang pangit yung dating. Makaka-apekto rin yan. Kaya ating sa Manalo, bakit? Syempre, yung mga nandoon, bastos. Di ba? Kumbaga, kahit papaano, kahit na ganun yung accent niya, Doktora yun eh. Nag-aral. Diba? Sabihin natin yung English niya, ganun. Okay, yung accent niya. Let's say yung accent niya, ganun. But come to think of it, she graduated with a degree. Diba? Parang sabihin natin mag-usap kayo ng Vietnamese o Vietnamese. For sure, jam-pack ang utak niya. So yun lang na ano ko, no? Siguro kung tayo dito, sabihin natin, okay, medyo nosebleed. Okay, totoo naman yun, nosebleed talaga na medyo ano. Pero yung magko-comment doon sa comment section, nakakahiya. Nakakahiya mga buweks, di ba? Lalo na yung si Doktora is a huge part of the organization. Di ba? Malaking party siya ng organization. Ngayon, kung ganun yung interview, for the very first time, of course, panonoorin niya ni Doktora yung interview. Panonoorin niya yung live nila, no? Tapos makikita niyo mga comment doon. Nakakahiya. Sana yung mga Pinoy, pag mga ganitong bagay, let's say hindi lang sa pageantry, sana ipakita natin yung sinasabi natin na we are very, we are kind, we are, yung, let's say yung, ano ba yun, yung hospitable na sinasabi, hindi lang yung dahil maghahain ka ng pagkain, ng merienda sa bisita mo, pakita rin ng mga Pinoy sa pamamagitan ng ganitong bagay, di ba? Kasi kung ganyan yung mga Pinoy, pinapakita nila yung ugali nila na paimbornal sa ganyang pagkakataon, nakakahiya. Ano, let's say sabihin natin, hindi importante yung sasabihin ng mga ano, wala tayong pakialam dyan, kapitbahay yan. Of course, it does matter. It does matter. Bakit? Kasi yung gano'n, nagre-reflect yun sa buong sangkatauhan, sa buong, anong tawag dito? Sa buong mga Pinoy. Diba? Kumbaga alam ng mga tao sa ibang bansa, oh, yung mga Pinoy, ganito, mababait, ganyan. Pero paano na lang pag yung mga ganitong comments na nakita na ng mga kapitbahay natin? Of course, may mga nanonood din dyan mga kandidata. Diba? Nakakahiya. Kasi ano eh, yung mga comments doon, English pa. Na may Tagalog. So alam mo, mga Pinoy yun. So nakakahiya. Sana, huwag na kayo makasala sa mga ganun na. Dito nyo na lang ibuga. At least wala naman dito si doktora. Okay lang yun. Pero doon mismo, sa isa sa mga big part ng organization, nakakahiya. Paano pa kung si Bawang yun? Eh di ba si Bawang medyo ano rin? Although si Bawang medyo maganda-ganda yung accent, pero meron pa rin siyang Vietnamese accent, di ba? So ayun, nakakalungkot lang sa part na yun. Sana pag mga ganitong pagkakataon, kumalma yung mga Pinoy. Hindi dahil hindi sa Atisa manalo yung kandidata nila. Of course, I understand that, no. Some people, some pageant supporters, they are doing this because of because for some reasons, no, na hindi nila gusto sa Atisa manalo, ganyan or whatsoever, or 'di ba? So ganun din nangyayari sa iba na kandidata. Pag hindi nila gusto itong isa, no, specific na natin sa Alexi Brooks, ganun din yung ginagawa nila. So, for me, tama na yung mga ganyan-ganyan. Tapos na yung Miss Universe Philippines. We are here now sa international pageant. At itong mga ito, like Atisa Manalo, lalaban siya sa international pageant. Sana, suportahan natin. Kung ayaw nating suportahan and hindi natin gusto sa Atisa Manalo, hindi ako, kung hindi nyo gusto sa Atisa Manalo, just leave it. I mean, don't watch it. Just quiet, no? Irespeto natin kung hindi nila kayang respetuhin si Atisa Manalo, respetuhin nyo na lang yung doktora. Diba? Kasi nakakahiya yung ganung ugali. Ang hirap intindihin ni doktora, pero at least Atisa is taking it as a grain of salt. Very good. Correct ka dyan, Ilocana. Like that, no? Kung sasabihin nyo na, yun nga yung sinasabi ko, ang hirap intindihin ni doktora. Totoo naman yun. Kaya nga lang, dito na lang natin ibuga. Wag na doon, 'di ba? Nakakahiya. At saka yan, very decent yung sinabi mo, Ilocana, na ang hirap intindihin ni doktora, which is true. Totoo naman talaga, no? Eh, yung mga comment kasi doon parang nosebleed, ano ba 'yan? Yung ganito ganyan. Alam mo 'yun? Parang ano ba? 'Di ba na 'yun, 'di ba? Tama ba ako mali? Baka si mali ako eh. Lunti ang Hardin, medyo magulo si Doc sa kanyang mga question. Okay naman yung question niya. Siguro she was trying to parang make it clear kung ano yung tinatanong niya, parang ganun. Because I believe na si Doctor medyo may ano siya, medyo kumbaga, I mean, aware siya na medyo alam niyo yun, merong language barrier. Siguro she was trying her best to explain to Atisa Manalo what was the question. So, yun yung nakita ko kay doktora. So, ako naiintindihan ko naman. Well, iba-iba tayo, no? Ako kasi immune ako sa mga Vietnamese. Pero siguro, kung halimbawa ako, first time kong makinig sa isang Vietnamese as magsasalita ng ganyan, siguro mahihirapan din talaga ako. So, I agree with you. GOS, panalo. Panalo yung hikaw ni Doc. Isa pa yan. Chanel kung Chanel talaga, ayaw magpakabog ni doktora. Diba, ang laki. Kapihan ni Beshi, need ko muna tapusin ang interview before ako magsagot sa poll. Thank you so much, Kapihan ni Beshi. Generic yung sagot dyan, niya dyan sa tanong. I think nakita ko yung comment mo kanina. Oo, generic, pero okay naman, naitawid naman. Okay lang yung next na sagot niya. Yes, nakita ko rin yung comment mo dun sa isang question kay Ate Samanalo. Okay din sagot niya. Maganda yung sagot ni Doc. Ayan, oo. Nakita ko rin yung comment mo. Maganda yung sagot ni Doc sa tanong niya kay Ate Samanalo kanina. Yung sinagot niya yung tanong. Maganda nga. On contestants, good answer. Speaking Vietnamese. Hello sa iyo. Mag-aral muna more on Vietnamese, Ate Isa, para mapukuraw ka sa Cosmo para sure win. Maging si Miss Grand, sa Miss Grand International. Hello sa iyo, True. Ayan, sabi ni Kapihan ni Beshi. Hello, Kana. I wonder how and why did they decided to be the interviewer for the love of God? Ito talaga ang nosebleed na literal. Ayan, mabuti na lang si Atisa, game na game din. So, totoo lang, totoo. Mm-mm. Professional, very professional, no? Ayan, okay lang yan dito na ibuga. At least tayo lang dito. Wala si doktora, di ba? So, okay lang. Which is totoo naman talaga ng nosebleed. Well, napansin ko kay Atisa Manalo, napaka-professional, napaka-jolly, napaka-witty. Okay-okay naman yung sagot niya. Para sa akin, okay yung sagot niya. Kasi yung mga tanong naman, hindi naman ganun kahirap. And aside from that, anong tawag dito? Meron ako napansin kay Atisa Manalo, yung isa sa mga improvements niya, eye-to-eye contact. Napansin nyo, nag-eye-to-eye contact siya kay doktora. Parang si doktora, tingnan-tingnan. So, yun yung isa sa napansin ko kay Atisa Manalo. And I'm very, very happy sa improvements ni Atisa Manalo na eye-to-eye contact dahil talagang yan ang kailangan pag may kausap ka, mag eye-to-eye contact ka, ganyan, di ba? Yun ang nagustuhan ko kay Atisa Manalo. Kasi yun yung hindi ko, yun yung napapansin natin during the Miss Universe Philippines pag may mga ambush interviews. Di ba si Atisa Manalo, hindi siya tumitingin sa ano sa kausap niya. So tingin siya sa baba, tingin siya sa taas, kaliwa kanan, pero ngayon, si Atisa Manalo ay talaga namang tutok na tutok ang mga mata doon sa ano, doon sa kay doktora. One thing lang na napansin ko, excuse me, napansin ko lang kasi yung kay, ano, kay, yung may tinanong si doktora, I forgot what was the question, but when Atisa Manalo was answering the question, and then she was talking about, I think, about her advocacy, parang medyo napapansin ko na merong, parang I don't know kung may binabasa siya. Napansin niyo yung parang tumitingin siya doon. Parang siguro meron siya mga ano, siguro na paghandaan niya. So parang ganun, which is okay lang yun, no? Okay lang yun. Kasi nga, syempre, ano naman yan, kumbaga, live interview, ganyan-ganyan, parang, napansin ko na parang meron siyang ano, meron siyang mga keywords. Parang kami, no? Nila Mama Sam, nila ano, nila RJ, nila Gaisel. Pag nagva-vlog kami, ako talaga, thoroughly talaga, nagbabasa akong ganyan. O kaya pag madali lang yung iba-vlog ko, meron talaga akong mga keywords lang. So, okay lang yun. So, napansin ko yung kay Atisa Manalo na parang tumitingin siya dun sa baba. So, parang several times, sabi ko, oh my God, parang dun sa part na yun, ang galing ni Atisa Manalo. Hindi ko sinasabing, oh, scripted, ganyan-ganyan. Ang galing kasi kung meron siya mga keywords, that means to say, napaghandaan niya talaga yung mga posibleng pwedeng itanong sa kanya. Eh kung sa online naman to, like for example sa Instagram, di ba? Who cares kung meron siya mga keywords? Ang mahalaga doon, nasagot niya yung tanong. Tungkol yan dun sa ano, sa kanyang advocacy. Yung parang binanggit niya yung advocacy. So, okay lang yon. Kasi napansin ko tumitingin siya dun sa baba. Pero maganda yung naibuga ni Atisa Manalo. So, yun. Very confident. Tapos, parang humahapya-hapya siya dun sa baba. And then, tutok ulit siya kay doktora. But I'm pretty sure, yung mga binuga ni Atisa Manalo, pretty sure na talagang, napansin ko kay Atisa Manalo that she was a very knowledgeable kung ano yung mga binubuga niya, na kung ano yung, kumbaga kung ano yung makakaya niya dun sa maisasagot niya dun sa question. Tingin ko naman yung effort niya ay talaga namang para sa akin palong-palo. Maganda yung sagutan ni Atisa Manalo dito compare sa mga sagutan niya sa mga previews or sa mga ambush interviews during the Miss Universe Philippines. So para sa akin yung sagutan ni Atisa Manalo dito, hindi lang niya naitawid, talagang halos lamunin niya na si doktora. At saka napaka ano niya, kumbaga napaka naramdaman ko yung pagiging confident niya. Alam mo yung hindi nanginginig yung salita niya, yung boses niya hindi nanginginig. Kumbaga kung ano yung tinanong sa kanya, meron na siya agad sagot. At saka marunong siyang maglaro. Bakit ko nasabing marunong siya maglaro? Kasi, halimbawa, nag-aanuan sila, nagbabatuhan sila ng, anong tawag dito, ng, halimbawa, tinuturuan siya ni doktora, oh, ganitong language, ganyan, 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 ganyan. I think you should do this, ganyan, 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 ganyan. So, napansin ko, parang, easy to be with si Atisa Manalo. So, game na game siya. Yun ang nagustuhan ko kay Atisa Manalo. So, kung, kumbaga, kahit na, medyo parang medyo awkward yung syempre, 'di ba? Tuturuan ka ng Vietnamese, parang ang hirap pick-upin nung accent nila, nung words nila, 'di ba? Tapos ikaw nandoon ka, tapos online pa. Kasi pagdating sa online, iba yung audio pag nag-uusap kayo ng live. So parang kahit papaano, nakita ko kung paano nag-e-effort si Atisa Manalo just to anong tawag dito, ipakita doon sa interviewer kay doktora kung gaano siya anong tawag dito? Kapursigido para dito sa Miss Cosmo International or Miss Cosmo 2024 na masungkit yung corona. Talagang sinasakyan niya bawat bato ng tanong ni doktora sa kanya. Yun ang nagustuhan ko. Very witty si Atisa Manalo. At saka very, ano siya, very jolly. Nakakatuwa. Hindi siya boring panoorin. Medyo na-bored ako kay doktora. But that's okay. Kapihan ni Beshi, hello Kahana, ganyan po talaga sila magsalita kahit dito sa US, kahit dito sa Australia, ganun din. Hanggang nahahasa na lang yung mga Vietnamese. Ayun. Ang tanong, nasagot ba ni Atisa Manalo? For me, yes. Nasagot naman ni Atisa Manalo. Oh no, hair styling, no makeup. Sana na-explain niya yung side niya. Well, actually, iniisip ko rin yun kanina. Sabi ko, ay sana in-explain ni Atisa Manalo. But since, hindi naman tinanong ni doktora na please explain. So that's okay. Kumbaga kung ano lang yung tinanong kay Atisa Manalo, yun lang yung sinagot niya. Pero siguro, I'm pretty sure, kung itatanong ni doktora na, please explain, ganun. I'm pretty sure Atisa Manalo will explain why her answer is yung isinagot niya doon sa tanong na yan. Wala ako maintindihan kay Doc. Grabe ka naman, Amanda. Sugali. Hello, magandang gabi sa'yo. Kapihan ni Beshi, naiintindihan ko si Doc kasi marami naman na Vietnamese dito sa US. O diba, parang na-immune na tayo sa kanila. Hello, Kana. Kapihan ni Beshi, Viet people here in the States, mas naiintindihan naman po maski sa Vietnamese restaurant. Hindi naman ganun kay strong accent. Mas madali maintindihan. Totoo yan, kahit dito rin sa Australia. Pero pagdating mo sa Vietnam, pagkausap mo yung mga Vietnamese, kasi I've been to Vietnam many, many times. So talagang hirap sila mag yung accent, hindi naman hirap mag-English. I know they can speak English language, pero yung accent talaga, yun talagang mahirap intindihin yung accent. On exercise and eating, good point. Ayan, sabi ni Kapihan ni Beshi, Alokana, may ganun talaga strong accent. Totoo yan. Kasi marami rin silang dialect sa Vietnam. Tulad ni natatandaan niyo si Miss Universe 2018 Vietnam, si Henny. Di ba yung accent niya? Kumbaga yung dialect niya. Kumbaga parang sa probinsya siya nakatira, di ba? Sa Vietnam. Yung accent ni Henny ng Miss Universe of Vietnam 2018, malalim yung accent niya. So ngayon, since malalim yung accent niya, yung interpreter niya during the top 5 question and answer, iba yung naibugang sagot. Yun yung mga himutok ng mga Vietnamese nung time na yun, no? Nung sumagot siya sa question and answer sa top 5. So sabi nila, yung sinagot ng interpreter, okay naman, pero kung maipapaliwanag talaga yon in English, mas malalim yung pwedeng maibigay ng interpreter. So ngayon, ang naging issue doon kay Henny, masyadong malalim yung dialect ni Henny ng Vietnamese, no? Na language niya. Tapos yung interpreter, siguro, hindi naman siya talaga parang lumaki sa Vietnam. Kumbaga, siguro he moved to America or different country na nagsasalita ng English, or maybe he studied the English in the English language. Tapos, siguro nung kabataan niya, nakakapagsalita siya ng Vietnamese, kaya siguro parang ganun, no? So, iba na yung pagkaka-explain nung interpreter dun sa sagot ni Henny. Or siguro, iba rin yung dialect mismo nung interpreter. Kaya hindi na ibuga o hindi na i-deliver, hindi na explain na maayos yung sagot ni Henny nung time na yun. Kasi ang sinasabi nila, kung ano yun ng English ng maayos, yung pagkalalim nung pagkakasagot ni Henny, baka pumasok siya sa top 3. So, yun ang nakikita ko dito. So, Meds Ray, they are both beautiful. I agree with you. Ang ganda rin ni Doktora. Ang ganda ng skin. Yung mga Vietnamese, magaganda yung skin nila. Kahit na yung mga vendors na nagtatrabaho sa, alam mo yun, sa yung mga vendors na nagtatrabaho sa street, kahit na yung mga nasa restaurants, mga waiters, oh my God, waiters, waitress, kahit na ano, basta makikita mo, ang gaganda ng skin nila. Parang bihira lang ako nakakita ng Vietnamese na may mga maraming tigyawat sa mukha. Ang gaganda talaga ng skin nila. Pati yung mga nagtitinda sa palengke, magaganda yung skin nila. Nasa jeans nila yung magandang skin. Tulad ng mga Taiwanese. Alam nyo ba, yung mga Taiwanese, para sa akin na, mas magaganda ang skin ng mga Taiwanese sa Korean. Mas magaganda yung skin nila. Kung ikukumpara mo. In general. On inner value good. Yes, I agree with you, Kapiani Beshi. Hello, Kana. Yeah, right. Pero sobrang hirap intindihin ng punto ni Doktor. Kapiani Beshi, on baiting or no makeup removal, hirap ng tanong, ha? Oo, medyo mahirap yung tanong niya yan. Pero nasagot naman ni Ati sa Manalo, di ba? Dermatology si Doktor. Jeepa. Hi, Mama Buex. Present. Love you. I love you too, Lucretia. Sumblingo. Magandang gabi sa iyo dyan. Dasky, hello. Nawala yung message mo. Kapihan ni Beshi. On beauty trends, Korean. Ayan. Kapihan ni Beshi on skincare. Okay naman, sagot. Masyadong makapal yung blush ni Atisa. Napansin ko rin yun, pero maganda. Maganda na yung pagkakalatag. On skincare procedure, I think good naman ang sagot niya. Ang init sa Pinas, totoo yan. Sa Vietnam, ganun din. Hello sa'yo. Haha, walay, wakay, wakay, breaks. Gary, it was painful to watch. Just joking. Look ever, wala ako narinig sa palive nila. Thank you, Doc, sabi ni GUS. Alante, sa mga nagsabing walay, ano gusto nyong sagutin ni Atisa? Eh, hindi naman niya kailangan magpa-impress dahil simple lang naman ang mga tanong. It is just conversation between the two of them. Actually, parang ano nga lang, para lang silang nag-uusap. Para lang silang, parang normal lang. Pagbigyan nyo na si Doktora, hindi naman sila nagre-reklamo, Alante, hindi sila nagre-reklamo sa ano, sa sagot ni Atisa Manalo, doon sa accent ni Doktora. Pagbigyan nyo na si Doktora, first IG live daw niya, at first time din as host, o diba? Jay De La Peña, as an ESL teacher to Vietnamese students, sa accent talaga nila yun mahirap baguhin, pero magaling sila sa grammar. Kaya ang sinasabi ko kanina, dun sa mga nagko-comment sa live, nakakahiya kasi syempre, yung accent nila, ganun talaga yung accent magagawa doon, no? Dito na lang sana natin sabihin, which is totoo naman, no, yung accent nila. Pero doon magko-comment sa live, nakakahiya talaga. Medyo naano rin. I hope hindi maka-apekto yung kay Atisa Manalo. Yung tulad nga ng sinasabi ko kanina, siguro sa accent lang talaga, ano, may problem. Hindi naman problema. Ganun talaga yung accent nila, no? I think kung mag-usap sila, Vietnamese to Vietnamese, tapos English yung usapan nila, I think they will understand each other. Pero kung iba yung kausap nila, ibang lahi, mahirapan talaga. But anyway, kung ganun man yung accent ni Doktora, pag ito, Vietnamese yung language na sinasabi, I'm pretty sure, tulad nga lang sinabi ko anina, definitely, Doktora is very knowledgeable. Kasi, syempre, graduate yan ng bachelor's degree, di ba? Baka ano pa yan eh? Baka nga nag-masteral pa yan. So, GMTV, hello, Wex, Mr. Actually, Vietnamese are really trying their best to communicate in English to be globally competitive. I believe that, no? Naniniwala ako dyan. Most of my students have reasons like working abroad and communicating with foreigners. I am. Jay De La Peña, don't belittle Vietnamese people because of their accent. Totoo yan. Hindi talaga marunong lumugar ibang kababayan natin. Nakakahiya pag-uugali. Oo, nakakahiya talaga. Buti sana kung dito lang. Ayan, sige, mag-usap tayo na nosebleed. To be honest, may pagkaganon talaga. No? Kaya nga lang, syempre, kung ganun yung naririnig mo, of course, we are educated people, no? Parang, nandun ka sa ano, comment section, doon mismo, kumbaga, huwag mo nang ibuga, di ba nakakahiya? At saka, it will affect Atisa Manalo. Kasi siya yung ini-interview eh, di ba? Kumbaga, maka-apekto din yun sa atin. Gusto ba natin maiisip na, ay, mga Pinoy pala, ganyan, mga bastos, di ba? Kasi yung comment doon, English pa talaga, tapos may Tagalog, eh talagang obviously Pilipino, sa pangalan pa lang Pinoy. So nakakahiya talaga. At saka syempre may mga nanonood dyan ng mga candidates, di ba? May mga nanonood dyan ng mga taga-ibang lahi, yung mga kapitbahay natin, mga chay-chay. Galit na galit nga tayo pag binabash tayo ng mga chay-chay, tapos ngayon, parang nagbigay na naman sila ng reason para ibash tayo, di ba? Nakakadismaya. Kapihan ni Beshi, uneducated yung mga nagko-comment doon, feeling mga expert Filipino, nakakainis. Oo, nakakainis talaga. Izana Korokawa, good evening, how are you feeling today? I'm good, thank you, how are you? Loka ever, haha, Pinoy kind sa personal, pero imburnal, sa keyboard. Filingera pala ka. Correct. Kapihan ni Beshi, mga Vietnamese, super nice yan sa mga Pilipino. Isa pa yan, totoo yan, di ba? Di ba, tagapagtanggol nga natin ang mga Vietnamese pag binabash tayo ng mga chay-chay, ng mga Hindu sa social media, di ba? Sila yung nangungunang parang gusto nila yung mga kandidata natin, sila yung nag-hype sa atin. Kumbaga, sila yung protector natin, di ba? Tapos ngayon, ganyan, nakakaloka, di ba? Hindi ko masakain yung hair ko. Nakakahiya. GUS, ganyan mga Pinoy sa chat ugaling kanal porkit hindi sila nakikita pero in person behave naman sila. Behave naman, oo, totoo yan. Matatapang lang sa ano, sa comment section. Jim TV, Mr. Actually, the important thing is that her speaking was understandable, the doctor, and yes, English is not their mother tongue. Diva? Baka nga mamaya pag nandoon ka, tapos kita mo sa Atisa Manalo, nababalubaluktot yung ano niya, yung dila niya, di ba? Pero, hindi siya pinagtatawanan ng mga Vichin, di ba? Siyempre may mga Vietnamese doon, or may mga ibang lahi doon. Kumbaga, sa Atisa Manalo, she was trying her best na banggitin, ibuga yung tinuro sa kanya ni doktora, di ba? Yung accent ni Atisa Manalo, hindi rin naman Vietnamese, di ba? So, parang sana, yung mga Pinoy na ganun, wag nang, alam mo yun, well, wala naman tayo magagawa, wala tayong control, no? Pero yung mga nanonood dito, I hope huwag nyo nang sundan yung mga ganong yapak ng ating mga kababayang Pinoy. Kasi nakakahiya talaga. Sa IG yun ba yung naganap? Hindi ba nila sinira ang or pwede bang isara ang comment section? Pwedeng sinara yata yung, eto pa nakakahiya, buti nabanggit mo yan. Kapihan ni Eshi, buti nabanggit mo yan. Napansin mo, nung few minutes after the interview started, nawala yung comment section. Nawala yung mga comments. Tingin ko tinurn off nila yung comment section. Nakakahiya. Nakakahiya talaga. So, ayun. Kasi napansin nyo yung whole duration ng interview, yung comment section nawala. Diba? Nawala siya. So, tingin ko tinurned off. Party Nobro Locks, nobody's perfect. Dapat humble lang tayo. Kung perfect ang English, we have to understand, ibang lahi siya. And di naman sila English country. Ang importante, good listener at marunong mag-comprehend. Exactly what Janine Togonon said. Diba? So dapat ganon, hindi yan sa ano, hindi yan sa language. Which or hindi dapat maging barrier yung language. Dapat kung balikan nyo na lang sinagot ni ano, ni Janine Togonon para mas ma-explain na maayos. Ang importante ang kaintindihan, nagkakaintindihan ang bawat isa sa conversation nila. Totoo. Lance Rafael, thank you so much, Party Nobrolox. Lance Rafael Vlogs, Angel Luxin is in the house. Wala sa Angel Luxin ngayon, hindi ako mapaglandi. Inaantok na nga ako. Na-promise ko lang sa inyo tong live na to, kaya talagang nag-live pa ako. Dapat nga matutulog na ako. Talagang puyat na puyat ako ilang araw na. Kapihan ni Beshi, first time ni Doc, huwag expect na mga fanay sa hosting Q&A ni Doktora. Totoo, first time ni Doc nga yan, no? Party Nobrolox, to be honest, Bwex, unang job ko sa BPO as call center representative, pero dati nilalait ako ng mga pinsan ko na Carabao English daw ako. Pero yung cousin ko na crowded, di matanggap-tanggap sa BPO. Yan ang masaklap, di ba? Hindi ka ganun kagaling mag-English, pero sinomplang mo pa yung naka-cum laude. May mga ganyan talaga. Gulong ng palad ang tawag dyan. Joe Cassie, Bwex, nalamon ba ni Atisa ang mikropono? Merong mga part na nalamon ni Atisa yung mikropono sa kanyang sagutan. Meron yung iba naman na parang ano lang, generic lang, tama lang, na itawid, okay lang. Para sa akin, okay na okay yung sagutan ni Atisa Manalo. Mm-mm. Napaka-knowledgeable niya. Nakikinig siya. Ayun yung napansin ko, Atisa Manalo din, no? Nakikinig siya dun sa tanong at nasasagot niya naman yung tanong. Kahit na hindi ganun kalalim, okay na okay pa din. Hello sa'yo. True, si Atisa Joker din siya. And she knows how to have fun and be relatable, which shows more of her personality. Hindi siya scripted, a very natural from the heart. Well, tonight, yan ang napansin ko kay Atisa Manalo. Hindi siya scripted. I agree with you. Loki Tan, hindi makuda si Atisa. Kung now lang yung tanong, yun lang ang sagot, nagkakaroon ng dead air. Ayun. Parang medyo hindi ko naman na-feel yung dead air. Medyo na-feel ko yung dead air ng konti kay Doktora. Emily Gidotti, hello Bwex, kamusta ka naman dyan? Si Doktora ba yan? Oo, siya si Doktora. Bet ko upuan si Kirk Bonda, not Kirk Popiolek. Walang yaka. Nelly Bartol, hi Bwex, magandang gabi sa iyo. Present ako ha. Hi, thank you. Musta ka? Paganda ka ng paganda. Diyos ko, haggard nga ako. Join ka na ba sa pageant? Hindi, Diyos ko Lord. Mapapaimbor na lang Pilipinas pag ako nag-join. Namiss kita, Nelly Bartol. Thank you so much. Jay De La Peña, di talaga sila nalabas ng expose ang skin nila sa araw, as in balot na balot sila palagi. Kahit ang main transport nila, motorbike. Ayan, sabi ni Jay De La Peña. Thank you. Tax refund, narinig nyo ba? In-explain ko yan dati, nung last week. I-explain ko ulit sa inyo. Dansky, binako-comment ko, Bwex, na guilty ako sa thought mo, pero mahirap talaga intindihin si Doc Ache. Ano ka ba? Okay lang yun? Okay lang na ano? Okay lang na, of course, I mean, ako rin, no? Ako rin talaga. Meron talagang language barrier. Kumbaga, nosebleed talaga. Magpakatotoo lang tayo. Totoo nga. Kaya nga, sumasang-ayon din ako kay Ilocana. Totoo naman na meron talagang language barrier. Totoo naman talaga merong problema. Hindi, huwag nating sabing problema sa accent kasi hindi problema yung accent nila. Ganun talaga sila. Normal talaga nila yon. Ang problema, yung mga Pinoy na nanonood na pinoproblema yung accent nila. No? So, kumbaga tayo, okay lang na, of course, hindi naman tayo pwede magpa-plastic na sabihin natin, oh my God, naiintindihan ko ganyan-ganyan, oh ganyan-ganyan. Hindi natin naiintindihan, hindi mo naiintindihan, eh, di ba? So, totoo naman, meron talagang paghihirap intindihin yung accent ni Doktora, no? But to think na live yun, tapos nagko-comment doon yung mga kapwa natin Pinoy na puro kabastusan, alam mo yun, walang karespeto doon sa doktor, makaka-apekto yun, hindi lang kay Atisa Manalo, pati sa sangkatauhang Pilipino na ganun ba mga Pinoy, mga bastos, di ba? So, halimbawa tayo nag-uusap tayo dito sa Parade of Beauty. Okay lang, sabihin nyo, okay, si Doktora ganito, ganyan. Okay lang, kasi wala naman si Doktora, di ba? Pero doon, na sa interview, hindi nyo napansin, tumitingin-tingin si Doktora doon sa, ano, sa comment section. Siguro, turn off ni Doktora yung comment section. Nakahiya. Pero very professional si Doktora kasi nga, tuloy-tuloy pa rin yung kanyang pag-interview kay Atisa Manalo. And aside from that, si Doktora, kumbaga, makikita mo walang nagbago sa itsura niya, di ba? Kumbaga, jolly pa rin siya, happy pa rin siya, ganun. So, ayun. Pero, tingin ko, aware si Doktora sa comments. Aware siya. Kaya siguro tinurn off niya yung comment section. Nakakahiya. Pero dito, okay lang yan. Magpakatotoo lang tayo. No? Pero pag-usapan natin, in a right manner, hindi yung parang, alam mo yun, hindi dahil wala dito si Doktora, eh, babastusin na natin siya. Di ba? So, ayun. So, there's no problem kung sabihin nyo dito na may, ano tawag dito, may nosebleed. Which is totoo naman. Pero okay lang yun. Wala naman dito si Doktora, di ba? So, pero pag-usapan natin in a right manner na hindi tayo makakabastos ng ibang lahi, di ba? Or, kasi tayo rin naman eh. Kumbaga yung accent natin, di ba? Hindi naman lahat ng Pinoy ganun, di ba? Ako nga, minsan, nag-feeling lang yung kausap ko or hindi naman Aussie. Yung hindi, I don't know, para kasing automatic sa akin yun. I don't know. Pagkausap ko yung Australian, nagiging Australian accent ako. Pero pagkausap ko yung Pinoy in English or mga, anong tawag dito, mga Asian, you know, mga kababae, hindi natin kababae, mga kapitbahay natin, mga Asians, pag nag-English ako, I don't know, siguro parang nahihiya din ako mag-Australian accent ako, parang ganun, no? So parang inaano ko na lang, binubuga ko na lang kung paano ako magsalita ng English in a normal ng pagsasalita ng English, no? Hindi ko na can I order some water? Hindi ako nagagaganon, di ba? Magagaganon ka, di ba? Kausap mo, hindi naman Australian, di ba? Parang ano. Pero pag kausap ko yung Australian, lumalabas automatically. Hindi, napapansin ko na lang ng kalagitnaan ng conversation. Oh my God, ganun na pala yung accent ko. Parang ganun. Boss Joshua, dating winner kasi si Doktora sa Miss Cosmo. Gaga, wala pang Miss Cosmo. Ito nga yung first time. GMTV, Mr. Actually, 10 years from now, we will be left behind by the Vietnamese cause at a young age. Now most of the kids, they are now studying English and most of them have American and British accent now. Ayan ang taray. Hello sa iyo. Wow! 82 license holder sa Miss Cosmo, ang dami for a first timer. Especially this is their first pageant ever. Yung iba, like Miss Charm is only 40 and Miss Grand is 60 plus, di ba? Ikaw ba naman, susme, ang laki-laki ng papremyo, may pa condo unit. Tama ba yon? Parang titirahan nila? Parang ang mahal-mahal ng condo na titirahan nila. Tapos may $1 million ba? Tama ba? Or $100,000 ba? Na papremyo? US dollars, at tapos meron pang pala luxury cars and everything, blah, 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 blah. And then my 1 million something for a charity something. Di ba? Nakakatuwa yun. Kung mapapanalunan ni Atisa Manalo yung corona na Miss Cosmo, yung $1 million, ang dami nung matutulungan sa Pilipinas. Grabe yun. Di ba? Hindi man mapapasakan niya sa kamay niya yung $1 million, pero mapupunta yun sa mga charity na gusto niyang tulungan. Diba? Nakakatuwa kung tapos ganyan yung asal ng mga kababayan natin Pinoy dun sa comment section. Nakakahiya. Nakakahiya talaga. Kasi eto mga ito, kung pagsasalitain nyo sila sa kanilang language, eh talagang ano yung mga yan. Tingin ko okay-okay naman sila. Hindi lahat, pero syempre, merong matatalino din yung mga yan. Para din yan sa atin. Kahit sa iba, sa may mga maayos, may mga hindi, may mga matatalino, merong hindi, diba? Kaya nga sabi nila, don't judge the book by its cover, diba? Dito nyo na lang i-ano sa Parade of Beauty. Huwag na lang doon, nakakahiya. Di ba? Anyway, Mom Wex, ano masasabi niyo dito sa interview ni Atisa Manalo kay Dr. Bigna? Sa tingin niyo ba nilamon niya ng bonggang-bongga ang mga questions ni Dr. Bigna at nasagot niyo ba ito ng tamang-tama at plakadong-plakado? At sa tingin niyo ba posibleng masungkit ni Atisa Manalo ang corona, ang kauna-unahang corona sa Miss Cosmo ngayong taon na gaganapin dito sa bansang Vietnam? Ibagsak niyo na ang inyong pinakamatitinding komento para makita ko rin ang inyong mga opinion. Hanggang sa susunod natin mga chika-chikahan. Bye for now mga Lex and I. Love you all. Bye! See ya!